President Nixon here. I'm hiring new losers to deliver the ice. And hurry up. I'm sweating like J. Edgar Hoover trying to squeeze into a new girdle.
You heard the good news. Save the earth, etc., etc. Bye.
Wait, where do we get the ice?
The wall? Oh, Halley's Comet, of course. The only sufficient source of ice cubes that don't have bugs in them.
Wow, mining a comet. That sounds fun.
Yes, there's no safer occupation than mining, especially when you're perched on a snowball whipping through space at 1,000,000 miles an hour. Ooh! Safe.
You're both alcoholic, whoremongering, chain-smoking gamblers?
No, it's just... neither of us can get up when we get knocked on our back.
What? I've seen you get up off your back tons of times.
Those times I was slightly on my side.
Interesting. Maybe we should test this erectile dysfunction of yours, Bender.
I think I hear my factor calling me. Oh, step,
yo. Thank you all for coming. It is my pleasure to introduce the host of the Kyoto Global Warming Convention, the inventor of the environment and first emperor of the moon, Al Gore.
I have ridden the mighty moon worm.
Good for him.
My fellow Earthicans, as I discuss in my book, Earth and the Balance, and the much more popular Harry Potter and the Balance of Earth, we need to defend our planet against pollution, as well as dark wizards.
Sure, blame the wizard.
What else
ever
we got?
Ever wonder what professor, it would be like to see Toy Story 3 in 3D?
Absolutely not! I won't speak! I've got nothing to hide!
Our next speaker is Professor...
I demand the floor!
Oh. Yes, it's your turn to speak.
I succeeded!
What was that?
A flaming burp.
Does it always do that?
It's not always a burp. We still have one problem, though. This robot will never meet emission standards.
Crap, Spackle! We'll just call it a sport utility robot and classify it as a light truck.
Well, I suppose the environment can take one more for the team. What a fool I was! If only I had made the effort to develop a cleaner burning robot!
I must go now to help collect cans on Jupiter.
Peace out, y'all! I wonder what it would be like to see Toy Story 3 in 3D.
Destroy all robots! Destroy all robots!
Wow!
And cry.
He's a family guy.
Ife. Huh? What? Ife. Huh?
Coming
what?
Up, a New Orleans man says his socks are finally dry. But first, the big news in entertainment this week is the lovable child actress Olivia Fuller.
Oh my God, Brian, that's Olivia from the Performing Arts School. Oh, what sort of overblown contract is that dreadful bitch landed now? Oh, this one's kind of nice. What? Olivia? Hey!
Stewie? Oh my God!
Yeah! Wow!
It's been a while.
Yeah, no, it has. Oh, so you're back in time?
Yeah, we're moving back into the old house.
Oh, that's, well, God, you look great. I mean, you're all in shape? She said yes. My God, I'm cooler than that cheetah from the commercials. Boy, this is a great city. I don't care what anybody says.
I know. Look at that sunset against the skyline.
I know. Wow, look at that.
A perfect end to a perfect day.
Yeah. Well, we should probably get home. This area gets really dangerous at night.
Oh, talk to whoever I want. I don't see a ring on my finger.
I, Stewie, take you, Olivia, to be my lawfully wedded wife.
Oh! All right, this is gonna blow you guys away.
Grandpa!
Oh my God! Is he breathing? Somebody call an ambulance!
Lois, maybe you better call two ambulances.
How is he, Doctor?
Mrs. Griffin, his internal injuries were much too severe. I'd estimate he'll be dead within the hour.
Dad, I'm so sorry I broke all your ribs and busted your spleen and punctured your lung. I don't know if you can hear me right now, but I hope you know. I love you, Dad.
Peter, come closer. There's something I need to say to you.
I'm here, Dad. What is it?
Peter, you're a fat, stinking drunk.
Oh, my God. He's dead. He can't be dead. There's got to be something I can do. Town drunk? Oh, my God. You mean he's the disgrace of the whole town?
You lads aren't from around here, are you?
Top of the morning, laddies. Let me cut you an Irish rose. Woo! I don't know exactly where the county Cork is, but I know where it should be.
Around here, the town drunk is a person of great honor.
Excuse me, sir? My name is Peter.
Pleased to meet you, lad. Name's Mickey.
Listen, this may be hard for you to believe, but you're my father.
Who am I now?
Yeah, I came all the way from America to find you.
I suppose it's money you're wanting. I owe you some allowance and so forth.
Oh, no, I don't want money. I just want to get to know you and be friends, so I can finally have a real dad who loves and respects me.
You can't be me, son. You and me are nothing alike. Just ask me sheep, O'Brien.
Whose leg do you have to hump to get a pint of Guinness around here?
Boy, it's amazing, isn't it? You get two fathers, and neither one of them wants anything to do with you.
There's got to be some way I can make him see that I'm worthy of being his son. But the only way I could ever impress him is if I was a fat, stinking drunk.
You are a fat, stinking drunk.
What?
You're a fat, stinking drunk.
Yes, from what he's told us, that's right on the money.
Challenge him, you must.
And I'm Hayden Christensen.
Wait a minute, Brian, that's it. I'm a fat, stinking drunk because my father is a fat, stinking drunk. And I gotta prove it to him. I have gotta drink him so far under the table, he'll have no choice but to respect me. Get me a beer, Brian. I am going to prepare for this as thoroughly as Ben Affleck prepares for a role.
Whoa, I got to be Henry VIII in 20 minutes. Hello, 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 hello. Got it.
My throat. I thought you got me a
rabbit. Well, maybe you should just open it up before you go flying off the handle, judging things you don't know anything about.
Is that no damn bunny rabbit?
What do you know? It's a snake.
I wanted a bunny rabbit. I was going to name him Nathan. That's Latin for warm, by the way. Nathan Scott Phillips.
Hey, look. Turn that frown upside down. You can still have a bunny rabbit.
Really?
With a little imagination, of course.
No, boy.
And look what we have here. Pipe cleaners, a stapler, and a pound of human hair.
I can make some fur and shape some ears for him and staple it all to his head.
Then you'll be able to have your very own long bunny rabbit that you designed. It's your chance to play God.
Hold still, Nathan. This will only hurt once. But damn, what it hurt.
He's thanking you for the gift of life.
Really?
Oh, that's a deep kiss, too, like the Europeans. You know, the French, they have to unhinge their jaw to show love.
Kind of feeling numb here. Is it supposed to really slow your breathing down like I'm kind of feeling?
Well, that's emotion overtaking your nervous system.
Well, come on, Nathan Scott Phillips.
What bunny?
Yeah, that got here all right. Very irresponsible with it.
And it came in that box?
I don't know.
Whoa, what is that over there?
I don't know.
Hold your ears.
Wait, don't.
What's wrong?
Make sure the camera's on first.
Yeah.
All right, how's the lights?
Oh, lighting's good.
Are they good?
Yeah, shake.
Now, do not touch the F-stop.
I'm not messing with your F-stop.
You got me framed up?
Oh, yeah, you're framed up.
Make sure I'm framed up, then blow her to hell.